5. And just before the bell, Al Silvani, Arguello's trainer, doing a lot of yelling into his ear. And I think he's telling him to step it up because right now, little Villamar Fernandez might be stealing this fight from you, so you better start moving. Let's see if he takes his advice. He's just looking to get in the big punch. That's what he's doing. He's just following Fernandez around the ring, and every once in a while, Fernandez is getting the licks in, and Arguello is missing with that left hand. And as I said earlier, Duran said that, or Stanton said that it's almost impossible to hit Fernandez in the head, and Arguello is finding that out. Last punch of the last round was a left hook, a good one, but it went completely over the head. Arguello is just stalking him. It off again. 3, 4, 5 good jabs by Fernandez. Fernandez, real good. There was a lot of force behind it. Arguello took it. It was a good punch. Best punch he's thrown so far. Best punch of the fight. 1 minute to go. Round 5. Another right hand by Fernandez. Two good hands. Left and a right by Fernandez. Right hand by Fernandez. He's really, really fighting now. He's fighting a real smart fight. He's punching and moving. And there's the elusive head again. Arguello just cannot find it. Arguello's got to be wondering what he's got in front of him right now. I don't think he ever figured this young man could fight as well as he does. He's no target. He gives Arguello no target at all. He hasn't hurt him. He hasn't landed a good punch on him so far in the 5 rounds. Good right hand. And Fernandez landed a right hand just at the bell. There he is, little Villamar Fernandez, and he is really fighting a fight. I'd have to have him in front. If I were keeping a scorecard, I'd have to have him in front right now. He's made the fight. He's got the better punches across. And we are now coming into the 6th round. And I would have to give him the fight up to now. It's a 10-round fight, of course. And a lot can happen in the next 5 rounds. But Villamar Fernandez is fighting the smartest fight I have ever seen a fight here in Madison Square Garden, at least. And he's doing exactly what he has to do. He's moving. He's getting his punches in whenever he can. He's getting punches in and snatches, and then he's moving away after he punches, he gets out of trouble. Boxing very well. Round 6. Arguello on the right. Fernandez on the left. And Fernandez is a big surprise to a lot of people here in Madison Square Garden tonight, I'm sure. Can pull this one out, it'll be one of the biggest upsets in boxing in recent years, I'll tell you that. No way did he have a chance, did anybody give him a chance to win this fight. I would have to have him on head on points right now. Up slipped in a right hand, Fernandez did. You can understand now why Fernandez went 13 rounds with Duran. He's a good little fighter. Yeah, he caught a right hand. That's the best punch that Arguello has thrown so far. He senses that he might have hurt him with it. And Arguello is coming on now. And he's punching. He's getting flicks in now. Both hands. And Fernandez has stopped moving. He's got to move out of there or he's in real trouble. Arguello, a barrage of punches. He hurt him with one, followed up with a barrage of punches, and he had Fernandez in a little bit of trouble for a while. Ties him up, the smart thing to do. No marks, he's not hurt now, he looks all right. But he took a barrage of punches from Arguello, the best flurry of the fight so far by Arguello. He sensed that he had Fernandez hurt. 1 minute to go in the sixth round. Is doing exactly what he has to do. If he is hurt, he's moving around, he's not trying any sort of an offense, he's just staying out of trouble. What he's got to do, he's trying to survive the round. And Arguello's coming on now. He's catching him. He caught him with two good left hands to the head that time from it close. Arguello finding the mark a little bit. Now there's another one. To the body and the head. Watch Arguello go to work. The round is almost over. That's it, the end of round six. Well, that's what they came to see. That's the Alexis Arguello that they came to see. Easily his best round of the fight so far. He sensed that he had Fernandez hurt about the middle part of the round, and he went on a barrage of punches. He had Fernandez in just a little bit of trouble. Here's another look at some of the action in that round. Arguello now figures he's got Fernandez hurt, and he's really going to work. That's a real good left hand to the midsection. Doesn't miss another one. Those body punches really hurt. And they're going to show up. They don't show up right away. They'll show up in a round or two. He's not missing any punches at all. Okay. Here we go with round seven. Alexis Arguello and Omar Fernandez. Arguello on the right. Round seven. And that last round was the best round of the fight so far. And Arguello is starting to pour it on now. Up to that round, Fernandez was doing very, very well. Could easily have been ahead on some of the scorecards, if not all of them. What he was trying to do now is cut down the ring on Fernandez. Fernandez is moving around the ring, using up almost all of the ring, but Arguello is trying to cut the ring off on him. Keep him in one spot, preferably in the corner. He's got him now. That's what he's doing. He's doing it very well, too. Watch him maneuver Fernandez and cut down the ring on him. Cut down the ring, I mean not give him too much punching room, not too much room to dance or move around. And he's maneuvering him very well. In the meantime, he's catching some left jabs by Fernandez. There's a lot more power in Arguello's punches than there is in Fernandez's. Fernandez lands them, the power is not there. But when Arguello lands them, they hurt. Those body punches, another right hand to the body, caught with a left hook coming in, and then the right hand to the body. There's 1 minute to go in round seven. Seconds. Flurry to the body didn't mean much. Not much power in any of those punches. Just the flurry. Taps. Ten seconds to go in the round. Round seven. And Fernandez might be stealing this round. That's the end of round seven. I don't know. How's your scorecard? Arguello had one big round. He's looking to knock out Guillermo Fernandez. In the meantime, Fernandez is boxing him very well. He's getting his punches in there. Survive if he can stay out of trouble and stay away from the big punch, he might easily win this fight. There are 11,875 people here in Madison Square Garden tonight. They're enjoying this one. I hope you are too. Say hello to all our friends out around the country, California, Alaska, Louisiana, some of our friends close by in Suffolk County in North Jersey. Nice to have you. We hope you're enjoying the fights from Madison Square Garden. This is John Condon, and I'm happy to bring them to you. Okay, round eight. And whoever thought it would go eight rounds? Nobody, I can tell you, who considers himself even half of an expert thought that Guillermo Fernandez could go eight rounds with a puncher like Alexis Arguello. But he's done a masterful job all the way through, except for one round. Got himself hurt a little bit, but he survived. Arguello is really going to have to go out now. He's got less than three rounds to do the job. He's going to win by a knockout. He's got to do a lot of work on Fernandez because Fernandez is not hurt. No marks, nothing. Still fighting a very smart fight. He's moving, punching when he can, staying out of trouble. Says, come on, let's do a little fighting, but that's not exactly what Fernandez has in mind. He's not going to stand in there and punch toe-to-toe with Arguello, not in a million years. He's fighting the kind of fight he has to fight to win. Arguello is getting a little bit exasperated. He's losing his cool just a little bit. To go in the eighth round. Oh, he's giving a little Ali. And he caught a right hand in the process. He's fighting Arguello now, but he's moving. And he is a very, very elusive target. Arguello's finding that out. Seconds, round eight. Ten seconds. Right hand by Fernandez, a real good right hand. Now he's fighting a
Arguello and beating him to the punch at the end of the round. He was fighting Arguello and beating him to the punch. I want to tell you, that little kid is really putting on a fight. He fought Arguello at his own game, beat him to the punch. He stood and slugged with him. The crowd here in Madison Square Garden went wild about it. It's something that he should not have done, but he did it and he won by it. He beat Arguello to the punch, and as I said before, this pesky little kid, Vilomar Fernandez, has got to have Alexis Arguello bothered somebody. Arguello cannot get the big punch across. As Larry Stanton said, the head of Vilomar Fernandez is a very elusive target, and every time that Arguello even throws a jab at it, it's not there. He surprised a lot of people, I'll tell you that. He's got a lot of fans here. Here we go at round nine. Arguello on the right, Fernandez on the left. Ninth round of a 10-round fight. Referee is Arthur Mercanti. Caught the tail end of that hook. Damage, but Fernandez's fans loved it. Up to now, Fernandez is fighting a perfect fight for an opponent such as Alexis Arguello. To do. Caught a pretty good stiff left hand that time. And it hurt him a little bit. Arguello's trying to sucker him in. He's got his left hand down low. He's trying to sucker Fernandez in. He wants him to slug with him. Get him in there. He's holding that left hand down low, hoping he'd come in, thinking that his jaw is a target, but Fernandez won't fall for it. He won't go for it. Took a pot shot out at that time. There goes the left hand. Is up again now. 1 minute to go in the ninth round. Out of trouble in time. Five seconds to go. Ninth round. Madison Square Garden Cable Television Sports Network will bring you another exciting doubleheader. August 25th, Wilfredo Benitez, undefeated welterweight, the number one challenger for the world welterweight title against Randy Shields of California. And in the second 10 rounder that night, it'll be Vito Antifermo, who is knocking on the door for a world middleweight title fight. And he'll fight Willie Classen. So both of those fights will be brought to you by UA Columbia, Madison Square Garden, Cable Television Sports Network. Be with us. I think it will be as exciting as it is here tonight. And this is really a fight that was unexpected. Nobody expected little Vilomar Fernandez to go 10 rounds with a great puncher like Alexis Arguello. Here we go, the 10th and final round. Referee Mercanti has them shake.